family turns the tragedy of their son's sudden death into a miracle for other families.
Fox 5's Marilyn Moore has their message now about the power of organ donation.
Gavin was a light in everyone's day. You know, he had this amazing smile. He had this little pep in his step. He loved to dance.
He was a bundle of energy at all times.
Gavin was an outgoing, healthy 7-year-old with big dreams.
When I would ask him just the last few years what he wanted to be when he grew up, he'd always say the world's biggest superhero. And I don't think we knew what that meant, but now he is.
It came suddenly one night after they had put Gavin to bed.
Gavin just said, "My tummy hurts. I had a bad dream. I feel like a monster slashed my tummy." And so we kind of just thought maybe he was getting like a stomach bug.
When it continued to get worse, his parents decided to take him to the hospital, but things escalated before they got there.
The closer we got to the 78, he actually said, "I can't breathe," and he stopped breathing. You know, I told Chris to hurry, because it was getting bad. And when we were getting off at Nordahl was when his heart stopped. And so, you know, I said, I think he just had a seizure, I don't know.
By the time the family reached the hospital, Gavin had no brain activity. What they thought was a stomach bug was actually a twist in Gavin's intestines.
It's very rare. It's not like something anyone could have caught from him. It's just a freak thing that happened.
Desperate, they put out a call for prayer on social media that went viral.
We had like millions praying around the world. It was so powerful. I just had this moment where I realized, you know, I don't think we're going to get the same miracle we wanted, but we could give the miracle to others. And so we shifted our prayers and said, please, let's just pray that he can help some other people through this tragedy.
Those prayers were answered. Gavin's one life ended up saving three.
We ended up finding out that his heart went to a 2-year-old and his liver went to a woman, I believe in Northern California, and then his kidney to a woman in Southern California.
In the deep pain of their tragedy, Chris and Tawni say they're finding purpose through Gavin's gift of life and seeing his dream to be the world's biggest superhero come true.
It was really crazy for him and I to be feeling so like sad about everything, but we felt joy when we found out that the transplants were successful.
Now they're raising awareness about what they describe as the beautiful process of organ donation. They're also starting a nonprofit in Gavin's honor called Gavin Our Hero.
Like the thought of Christmas really like broke our hearts, but the thought of using some of his organization to go shop for the kids at Rady's and shop for the families, just like I think this is really going to help us through this process.
Marilyn Moore, Fox 5 News.
Well, that story has been playing out all over the place for the last few weeks.
Here now with us, Gavin's parents, Tawni and Chris. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
I can't imagine, you know, it's always impressive that you guys go on this mission to help others when a tragedy like this happens. This is still very much raw for you guys. This happened last month.
Yeah.
How are you maintaining? How are you surviving, I guess, at this point?
I think there's some strength we found through our community and family and friends. Mm-hmm. We've had people sending their love and prayers. We're finding strength from somewhere. I don't know from where. I didn't think I'd ever want to leave that hospital and leave him there. So I think through his story, we're finding strength and there's just something keeping us going on. Because this is so out of our nature to even share everything and be so open about it. But
right.
I think that our grief journey is different from most and everyone grieves in a different way and that's okay. But this is by going by the love of the community and sharing his story is giving us purpose.
And you took something that's so tragic. All of us parents who have heard this, we have our own kids. So many of our kids have the stomach bug. They wake up, they say, "Ouch, mommy, it hurts."
Yep.
It's hard for a parent to hear this and to see what both of you are going through. But at the same time, Heather and I were watching the story this morning. She had tears in her eyes when she was watching this. And we looked at both of you and said, "Your strength. Look at what you're doing. You're talking about your son." Tell us a little bit about what happened afterwards and your decision to share his organs.
So when we were in the hospital, you know, we were all kind of hoping for a miracle. And Chris and I kind of knew like that since he had no brain activity, them coming back usually doesn't happen. And so we kind of realized, you know, we have the power to give not the power, but we have the ability to give a miracle to others. And those parents that have been waiting for that call, and through LifeShare, we were able to do the organ donation process, and it was actually really beautiful. We learned a lot we didn't know before, and it just, we never thought we would find joy again. And after we got home from the hospital, I literally waited all day for the phone call to see if his organ transplants were successful, because towards the end, his organs were getting a little bit sick.
Right.
And so when we found out that his organs, his heart went to a two-year-old, and that he was able to save two women in California with his liver and his kidney,
my God.
We just were crying tears of joy. And it was, we found that through this process, it gave us strength or hope versus it just not doing anything.
You mentioned, it struck me when you mentioned, you know, the, you're still in this mourning process and the healing process, but the organ donation, I would think, it gives purpose and meaning and a reason for all of this in a way that, because otherwise you can't comprehend how this could happen to a sweet 7-year-old little boy. Mm-hmm. But is this a way for you essentially to have a mission for all of this and why it happened? To wrap your mind around it almost.
Exactly. It's we have hope that in a year we'll be able to meet the families.
Yeah.
And it kind of just started, just this nonprofit started on its own. Mm-hmm. And we kind of feel like through Gavin, we want to help make the community a better place. Rady Children's was, there's angels that work there. And even though it was the most tragic experience we've ever went through in our lives, there was so much beauty and kindness and love, and Rady's, we were comfortable, and they made the process actually beautiful. Mm-hmm. Like, we're trying to, it's like a beautiful tragedy.
Speaking of beautiful, Chris and Tawni, I keep glancing down. I see a piece of paper that says from Gavin. What did you bring with you? What is that?
So this, he just made this like 2 weeks before everything happened, and he wrote us a little note.
I saw that. I can't.
When I got home, that was the first thing I found, and I will say that I was on the ground crying after reading it. But you know, he just said that, you know, he loves his family and that he's happy, and so that kind of made us feel, at least he was happy, and we gave him a good life, you know.
Yeah, it says to family from Gavin. I love my family. You are the best. I'm so happy.
Yeah.
I saw that in front of you. I couldn't even. You brought us these bracelets. It says, "Gavin, our hero." Little significance behind that for you guys?
Yeah. So recently, the last actually couple of years, I'd asked him, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" And he says, "The world's biggest superhero." And we really never knew what that meant until recently. We said, "Oh my gosh, he saved 3 lives confirmed, and then through the other processes, he could save upwards of 100 people just with like tissue."
Wow.
They can help save babies with cleft palates and soldiers. I okayed for it to go overseas for soldiers that might need it. And so our friends actually got those made. And it's just become now, like, our friends are starting GavinOurHero.org, and they know us, and they know, they're like, "We know you have a GoFundMe that you didn't ask for," because I never want anyone to think we're doing this for any other reason than love and the community. And they said, "We know you. You're going to do something better. You're going to make the world a better place through all this." So we're just trying to focus on everything positive.
We're all parents here. I mean, what you guys went through is unimaginable, obviously. And the strength that you've shown just in thinking so quickly about helping others, it's remarkable.
Thank you.
So we thank you guys for sharing your story with us, and we know that even sharing this right now will help others. And obviously the GoFundMe page is, there's a link on our website now, so if you want to go there, you can, to help out. Thank you both.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We're sending you
appreciate
both love and support. Thank you both for coming on.
Thank you.